Good morning, guys. Right, I'm up at Twyford. What was it, 30 odd years ago I used to come here on a regular basis. It's official Wednesday matches and the league's up here. And then Twyford Farm, as it was called then, was taken over by new owners and they stopped the fishing. And now Howard Kay has managed to secure the fishing again. And this is the first match in probably 30 odd years on you. So it'll be interesting. What I remember of it, of course, is the island pegs. Anyone who follow my vlogs will see that I made a video many years ago, and Tom Pickering was on it, and Jan Porter won the match, and I interviewed him afterwards. Yeah, so brings back memories. All I know that it used to be a bit peggy. I hope it's a bit better than that now these days. We'll see. Yes, on the video, I was next to, it was Dean Barlow and the Shakespeare captain. Got his name. That's for bloody age for me. Anyway, I'm going to get some breakfast now before they all turn up. See you in a bit. Okay, just sat to turn up now. I was just arrived with the bait. All the pool's been paid for in advance, so should be a matter of straightforward drawing for the pegs. They're all starting to gather now. Some old faces.
Right. Well, who was here for the last match at Twyford?
Trevor Chilton.
How many years ago is it? When was the last match?
30 years ago.
15 years ago. So we've done it. It's ready. Ready to go. It's going to, I hope, be an iconic venue again. And there's no reason it can't. We used to have 125 pegs. There are now 64 very long pegs. Every single peg has been cleared. Every peg has a number on it. Platforms are good on some pegs if you want to get a bit further out, but nobody has to get in the water. You can fish from the bank. It's taken a lot of effort. There's been a lot of negative comments flying around, lots of stuff. It won't be ready. It's ready on Sunday, and we'll keep it ready. It's going to be a fantastic venue again. There are fish all the way along it. Every peg is full of chublets for some reason. There were bream rolling on the island. If you draw the island, as it's dry, we're going to let you drive in convoy onto the island. And the island is pegged 1 to 12. But the 5 mile an hour speed limit is to be strictly adhered to. We've got a new road in, we don't want it chopping up. There are parking bays all the way along for other people, so I'm just going to tell you the parking bays. So if your pegs 1 to 12, obviously you're on the island and you can drive carefully and slowly onto the island. Parking bay 2 will be for pegs 14 to 19. Parking bay 3 is for pegs 20 to 26. Number 4 is for 27 to 32. Parking bay 5, 33 to 38. Parking bay 6 is 39 to 45. Number 7 is 46 to 52. And then there's a 7A as well, so you can drop into that, which is cut out in the grass verge. 46 to 52, yeah, 7 I've just said. Parking bay 8, for those on the high bank, that is for 53 to 64. Okay, and you can always ask me as you draw. certain things. We, obviously, the dog walking community have, they've always, you've never been able to let your dogs off the lead, but everybody does. Okay, but we don't want any animosity, so they've been told not to let their dogs swim. They shouldn't be off the lead. Please come back to me at the end of the match if they do that, because we are going to nip it in the bud. An awful lot of hard work has gone into this place, so therefore we don't want any litter. There are litter bins all the way along. It's going to be a fantastic venue. I hope you have a great day, and I'm really pleased you supported today. I've got a few people that have not yet turned up. Steve may have just seen arrive.
Well done as well, Howard.
Thank you. Yeah.
Well done, mate.
Thank you.
Well done.
I've got 59. I've had two people pull out in the night after I'd sorted all the pegs out. So I'm leaving all 60 pegs now in there. So there'll be one peg that isn't drawn. Okay? So you don't have to register that you've on a sheet, because once you've gone to your peg, I'll be coming down and marking down on the weighing sheets that's where you are. We will have two sets of scales at the end. So one working from peg 64 and one working from peg 1. So you don't need to worry, we'll meet in the middle. Hope you have an amazing day. You can please take your draw. Again, in the it is COVID secure, so but you can one at a time just come and get your draw. We will do it as people appear on the sheet. So if you take your draw, open your envelope and put the card back on the table and the envelope in the rubbish bin there, please. Right. Fishing 12:30 to 5:30 to get the best of the fishing. Okay, and remember, if you're 1 to 12, you can drive onto the island at 5 miles an hour. Can Kieran go down to the slope where they drive down?
Yeah.
So they know which way to go onto the island.
Yeah,
if you do, can you do that now? Because we're going to start the draw.
Yeah.
Thank you. Right, Mal Watson.
No pressure, Mal.
He's down there, mate.
He was the last one who fished the last match.
17.
It's not that Gordon, is it?
Lovely. Thanks, man. Leon Blundell. Always one sneaky
watch. He loves it round the back.
11.
Trev, let's do it together.
Green. Smack bang in the middle.
Green.
I'm glad that one's gone.
I'm going to beat you.
The most annoying man in match fishing. It's Chalky.
Yeah. 28.
Okay, there. Got to be Sir Branson. Right, anyway, peg 40. Apparently that's in the old 80s, and what I remember, it wasn't a very good area. But who knows? It's a new venue. You know, it's a new venture for Howard, fair to swim. Looks promising. Good payouts today by the sound of it. Let's hope we have a good day's fishing anyway. Right, let's get to the peg. One problem for the viewers as well, just if you ever come here. I thought they said you could drive to your peg, but they said no. You've got to go into a parking bay and then trolley down. And I haven't brought my trolley with me. So I'll have to make a couple of journeys by the sound of it. Anyway, not to worry, let's get down there. Let's have a look at the peg. Well, we've got drive down the track. My first impression is all overgrown compared to how it used to be. Never used to get all these trees here. Of course, I'm talking 20, 25 years ago. It's like a jungle. Packing bay 5. I'm packing bay 6. This could be it by you. Well, next one. Well, you're not going to believe it. It's 25 years ago since I fished here, and I'm in the same area as I was all them years ago. Do you know what numbers are? Do you want numbers? What numbers are they? Do you know?
37 was just the other side of that tree.
Right, oh, I'm 40, so I'll be by
you
then.
I'm 42, so I reckon it's down here.
Somewhere. By there, lovely. Okay. Okay, peg 40. As you say, luck of the draw. I got a peg that's got no platform, so I'll have to get in the water. Peg 40 there. Yeah. I have to go and get a platform now, and wade out a little bit because I won't be able to fish it from here. That's a fact. And I noticed opposite, there's platforms which have been put in by a club that own that stretch. Okay. Well, I've just come down to have a look at the island pegs, and Steve Mayer, I'll fly on peg too, got a lad there, Jim Burton.
Hi Clive!
Hello Jim!
Excellent!
Good?
How good are we? Out here, in the fresh air, doesn't matter, does it? If we catch, that's a bonus.
And now I guess where Russell's gone today, twinning.
He could catch.
Yeah.
He's ugly enough to catch.
That's one, Jim.
Have a good one.
And you, mate. Yeah, all the flyers. The old island pegs always used to win all the matches. And I expect they'll do it again today. But we'll see. I mean, there's a couple of nice pegs in the 30s. Lots of fish topping. Yeah, this is the old island now, and they can park on the island and walk to their pegs. So, yeah. Right, I better get back, because I've had to walk along and chat with everyone, almost. Just asking me what it was like in the old days. I don't think it's going to change. I think the weights should come along the island here. Right, let's get back. Okay, well, unfortunately, I got a problem. When I tried to go out, I put my waders on, and I nearly sunk right up to my chest, and I was stuck. So I didn't fancy going out any further, otherwise I'd be in trouble. So I've had a fish more or less closer to the bank. I positioned my stand, and I got my maggots and hemp. And it looks as though I've just got three methods here today, and that's a little feeder, a waggler, and a stick. So I just have to see how it goes. I'll just loose feed. Now, the problem is, I just had a look at the other pegs further down, and they look like Mr. Crabtree water, basically, and there's fish topping and trees in the water and hanging bushes and all sorts. Here, we're looking at a barren bit, except for a couple of trees opposite, you know. Anyway, unfortunately, this area, if I remember rightly, wasn't very good 25 years ago. It was a barren bit. It's the high 80s and 90s, which is never really any good. But there you are. I'm here now, so we're going to take see what I can do today. Be nice to catch some fish. There's a few minnows topping, but I'll be after them. Okay, just wait for the all in now, another 10 minutes.
You got fish topping all over the place here. The last time you filled one down here, I think Jan Porter won it, didn't he?
He did, up on the island.
I don't remember, yeah. I think I've still got your video somewhere.
Have you?
How are you, man? Oh, there we go.
Okay, all in. So a couple of lines of attack. One's going to be down the middle, one on the inside. Just give that a minute now. Try and see if I can build a swim up. Build it up if there's any fish there. It's interesting what Billy Macon was saying about, taking your time, build a swim up, knowing that you only need to catch one fish every 20 minutes, every half hour, and over the 5 hour match, you build a weight up. That's if you're going for bigger fish. Well, I'm hoping there's going to be some treblets here. Roach are not showing, so it's either going to be treblets or perch. Start on a waggler. I got two swan. Actually, this is a stick load I just picked up by mistake. Try the stick instead. It's a four number four. Oh, there's a boat coming. Marvellous. Somebody bawling in below me. It might work, you never know, ground bait. Bloody marvellous. Right through my swim. There we go. Oh, and another one. Start on the inside. Roach. A virgin roach, never been caught. My first fish for 25 years on this venue, and that'd be a lovely little roach. Good. I think those boats done me a favour there. They wouldn't have started on the inside. Talking about, there's another boat coming. Oh, I hope it's not going to be like this all day. Just snag the bottom in. Yeah, the swim is actually slows down on the inside. Nice little steady pace, but in the middle it's like flowing through. Another roach. Another boat coming. Thank you. it. I'll have to change my tack with the Wagner because they're going right down the centre of the river and they're stirring it all up. Now, the chance of fish are not going to stay there, do they?
Thank you.
So I might have to go further across, like, you know, out of the main flow. So I'm finding maggots further across now. Bit of a snag pit. Minus one hook. I usually tie my own, but I managed to get a couple of matrix hooks to nylon, so I don't know whether I trust the knot on it. Yeah, looks alright to me. Shame they stopped making these. They're very, very light. Very, very sharp. When you've got to catch something and you... when you've got to touch something and it sort of catches it. Including my fingers. I think he's a virgin fish, never been caught before. Perch. Leak. Oh well. Bleak. I'm bleak now. Just cast a little bit further downstream to try and avoid them. Another boat coming. There's a man waving at me. It's unbelievable, the boat traffic on you. I'm sure the fish are used to it. And if you notice, I hold the rod between my legs. But don't use a rod rest. Put a rod rest, you become lazy, I think. There's a massive boat coming now. Oh. It's a bloody seafaring bloody boat now in the river. But a massive anchor. Waving at me. Right, that little flurry of fish have gone. That's you know, quite often the case. You know, there's a couple of fish will have a little peck right at the very start. So I'll leave that alone a minute. I'm going to go across on the waggler just to see if there's anything across there. Putting double maggot on, hoping to catch a chub. Puppy. I think I'm getting pestered by bleak. I'm going to change a shot on her. put another 10 on, so it'll be a slower drop instead of an 8.
How are you getting on?
Hiya, mate.
Catching?
Just some bits, you know, a couple of roach and everyone catching, I suppose, yeah.
No, your first one I'll come to, I'm going that way.
Yeah, 40, peg 40. I tried to get out there, but I started sinking, I thought, oh.
Yeah, it is gravel underneath, though.
Is it? Oh, perhaps I should have gone further.
Yeah, it's where the digger was, and it's oh, slowly
going. I might say, okay.
I'll leave you to it.
Oh, I don't. Howard, the organiser. Thank you. little chublet on a double maggot 14. I'll scale down in a minute, you know. I'm taking an opening gambit, you know, with a bigger hook, in case there's bigger fish there. Right, I've come off that come back inside. I'll change my hook in a minute, put a smaller hook on across. Any good yet, Clive?
Only, you know, little bits, like, you know.
No,
little roach meat, little chubbets, you know.
Yeah.
Not that bit.
Bloke, two up, die of a lad. He's probably best I've heard. He's got five little pommies, a couple of little 6-ounce chub.
Oh, that's a bit.
All on the stick.
Yeah, yeah.
Andy Brutton's got 3 or 4 chublets.
Yeah.
Vicky's got a couple of little chublets, but they're only like 3-4 ounce.
Yeah.
A couple of perch and a little roach. So
all, pretty much all the same, Floyd.
Yeah, yeah, it sounds like, doesn't it?
Yeah, yeah. All the best, son.
Cheers, mate.
you. This helicopter's a couple of little troublets across. And I've had a roach and a perch over there. Only little ones. I think I've got to get further across though, under that tree there. Yeah, roach, I say. I was slacking the line then. You know what happened to me, and I got a farmer opposite there now, piling up all the straw right opposite me, creating a commotion. the bird's nest here. Okay, guys, well, there we are, the match is over. What can I say? People are walking up, seeing the island. There's loads of double figures down there. Yeah, nothing's changed after all these years. We've caught fish up along here, like, you know, there's somebody's caught the skimmer above me. He's had a couple of fish below me, but I've caught fish on and off all match, only little things like that, little roach, perch, little chublets, like, you know. Enjoyed it, enjoyed it. I'll weigh in anyway just to see what I've got. Just to say I've been back to Twyford. As I said, lovely water, mind. I mean, a lot of these fish have been catching, haven't been caught for a while. You can tell that by the mouths and the scales, you know. But I expect it could get better, I think, you know. Once some more feed's gone in and the fish got used to it, I think it should be okay. Yeah, so what can I say? The island pegs where you want to draw. Saying that, I think Chalky and a couple of them up above the island, they've caught a couple of fish as well, where I went this morning, had a look, and there's a lot of fish were topping there, so yeah. So I expect they've got some weights as well. So it's not, yeah, it's not, well, no, it's not that bad, like. I don't know what they've got. I'm in the worst section, which is like the middle, you know, which isn't all that clever. I hear they've caught a couple up the top, but we'll soon see now when they come to weigh in. Okay, there we are then. So 3 pound. You know, as I said, I've enjoyed myself. I've caught plenty of little fish, you know, little chubbers, little roach. Surprising I caught roach, actually. then I had a little bit of a late run as well, you know, only small little chubblets on the waggler. And that was it. So, they come along and they said that there's a 5 pound above me of skimmers, and above him there's 9 pound. A bream, that's Leon Britton. I didn't expect them at all today. Not up here anyway, but down on the island, apparently, there's about 4 or 5 of them have all caught bream, and they're all admitting to 20 odd pounds. So, as I said, if I can get the results, I'll pin them on the end. Otherwise, I'll see you on the next match. I've come back to the way the draw was, and there's nobody here, so they must be having the results somewhere else or online, I expect. Okay. Thanks for watching. Let's hope we get a better draw next time, which will be Saturday now, back at Evesham. See you then. Okay, right. I've just heard the results. some fantastic weights. A couple of 60s, 50s. Oh my God. I'll try and put the record, put it up if I can at the end of the post here.